वेलकम टू द लेक्चर ऑन ब्रिक मेसनरी. सो इन टूडेज वीडियो वी शैल डिस्कस वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ बॉन्ड्स विच आर यूज इन ब्रिक मेसनरी. फर्स्ट वी शैल डिस्कस वॉट इज बॉन्ड इन ब्रिक मेसनरी. बॉन्ड इज द अरेंजमेंट ऑफ ब्रिक्स और स्टोन्स इन ईच कोर्स सो एज टू एंश्योर द ग्रेटेस्ट पॉसिबल इंटरलॉकिंग and to avoid the continuity of vertical joints in two successive courses both on the face and in the body of wall. So here different technical terms are used. So bond is nothing but it is the arrangement of bricks or stones in each course so as to ensure the greatest possible interlocking and to avoid the continuity of vertical joints in two successive courses both on the face and in the body of wall. So bond is nothing but it is the arrangement of bricks in a course. Course means already we have discussed horizontal layer. So under this horizontal layer, we have to arrange the bricks in such a way that there will be proper interlocking and verticality of joints will be avoided. म्हणजे एका कोर्समध्ये जो व्हर्टिकल जॉईंट दुसऱ्या कोर्समध्ये एकमेकाच्या वरती यायला नको. इन दॅट केस द मेशनरी विल बी वीक. सो बॉन्ड इज नथिंग बट इट इज द अरेंजमेंट ऑफ ब्रिक्स और स्टोन्स इन अ कोर्स so as to ensure the greatest possible interlocking and to avoid the continuity of vertical joints in two successive courses both on the face and in the body of wall. So here you can see in this course these are the vertical joints, right? And in this course these are the vertical joints. So these two vertical joints are not one above the other. So this is called as bond. The bond is nothing but it is the arrangement of the bricks in a course in such a way that in a such a fashion that the verticality of the joints in two courses in successive courses it is avoided. Ha ithe ek joint isal ithe ek isal ithe zigzag disto. So this is called as bond for and this is only for achieving the strength or you can say interlocking of the bricks. Now there are different types of bricks. Few bonds are studied here: header bond, stretcher bond, English bond, and Flemish bond. Under this Flemish bond, again there are two types: single Flemish bond and double Flemish bond. Now, very first is header bond. Already we have discussed what is the header and what is stretcher, right? Header means what? When bricks are laid with their length perpendicular to the face of the wall, it is called as header. Means here in case of this, you can see how the bricks are laid with their length perpendicular to the face of wall, right? And this is called as, this arrangement is called as header bond. The bond in which all the bricks are laid as headers in every course of the wall is called as header bond. The overlap is kept equal to half width of the brick, which is obtained by using a 3/4 bat in each alternate course at quoins. This bond is commonly used for constructing staining of wells means wells means viriza kada, footings of walls and columns, corbels, cornices, etc. This bond is suitable for walls of lightly loaded load bearing structure. So in case of header bond, you can remember when bricks are laid with their length perpendicular to the face of wall, the bond is called as header bond. And in case of header bond, to achieve the interlocking, to obtain the interlocking, here the corner bricks are used, which are called as 3/4 bats, pauna, 3/4 bricks. It is used here. So here you can see continuity of the joint is avoided. Here also same thing in the next course. Here 3/4 brick is used in the corner and continuity of the joint is avoided. So where this type of bricks are used? These are staining of the wells, म्हणजे विहिरीचा कडा, footing of the walls. ज्या आपण फुटिंग करतो फाउंडेशन त्याच्यासाठी वापरतो, कॉलम्स, कॉर्बेल, कॉर्निशे. दिस बॉन्ड इज सुटेबल फॉर लाईट वॉल्स, लाईट लोड बेरिंग वॉल्स. इवन तुम्ही जर घराचं काम करतो आणि बघितलं, आपण जेव्हा प्लिंथचं करतो, ज्योतेचं काम मराठीमध्ये म्हणतात, प्लिंथ केल्यानंतर शेवटचा जो थर ॲडजस्ट केला जातो, इट इज ऑलवेज हेडर कोर्स फॉर ॲडजस्टमेंट पर्पज. सो दिस इज रिगार्डिंग हेडर बॉन्ड. नाव स्ट्रेचर बॉन्ड. So in case of stretcher bond, as already this we have discussed, This is called a stretcher bond. When length of the brick is parallel to the face of the wall, it is called a stretcher bond. The bond in which all the bricks are laid as stretcher in every course is called a stretcher bond. The length of the bricks are thus along the direction of wall. This bond is used for half bricks wall only, such as cavity wall, partition walls. So this is a single brick construction wall bond. In case of this, the thickness of wall is equal to the single brick width. म्हणजे इंटरनल वॉल जे आपल्या घरामध्ये असतात दोज आर कन्स्ट्रक्टेड विथ द हेल्प ऑफ दिस स्ट्रेचर बॉन्ड. पार्टिशन वॉल्स कम्स अंडर स्ट्रेचर बॉन्ड. सो दिस इज द प्लान फॉर फर्स्ट, थर्ड अँड फिफ्थ कोर्स, अँड दिस इज द प्लान फॉर सेकंड, फोर्थ अँड सिक्स्थ कोर्स. सो हियर यू कॅन सी द फर्स्ट कोर्स, हियर द फर्स्ट ब्रिक, सेकंड ऑल आर द स्ट्रेचर, ऑल आर स्ट्रेचर. हियर इन द सेकंड कोर्स दिस इज ॲडजस्टेड लाईक दिस. Again, stretcher course. So here, their header will be visible from front side. So it is header, stretcher. Again, stretcher. It is also in stretcher, but in another direction, L section. So this is called as stretcher bond. Now, next is English bond. This is a special type of bond. We shall discuss. This bond consists of headers and stretchers laid in alternate courses. In case of this, this bond consists of headers and stretchers laid in alternate courses. What is the definition? So here you can see, this is the stretcher course and this is the header course. So headers and stretchers, these are adjusted in alternate courses. These are laid in alternate courses. English bonds are the strongest of all the bonds. It provides rough appearance, especially for one brick thick wall. There are no noticeable continuous vertical joints in the structure built in this bond. In case of this bond, only stretcher and headers are used. Normally, brick beds are not used as far as possible. Brick beds are not allowed. And that's why here in case of this, vertical joints are less. So this is the strongest bond. There is a chance of penetration of damp through transverse joints. Dampness is possible. Appearance of English bond is not as good as Flemish bond. It is having good appearance, but with compared to Flemish bond. What is Flemish bond? That we shall discuss in next slide. But this English bond, it is having less appearance with compared to Flemish bond. So this is the plan for English bond. And here, this is the elevation. So this is one brick wall and this is one and a half brick wall. This is the plan for one and a half brick wall and this is for one brick wall. This is half and this half. So obviously this will be one brick, this full brick, this half brick. So it is called as one and a half, right? So this is the plan for one and a half brick. This is the plan for one brick. Elevation will be same. So here, to avoid the continuity of the vertical joints, this type of coin is also used. Now next is Flemish bond. The bond in which headers and stretchers are laid alternately in the same courses. Headers and stretchers are laid alternately in the same course is called as Flemish bond. In English bond, you will find this course is only of stretcher, this course is only of header, but that is not the case in case of Flemish bond. So here headers and stretchers are laid alternately. So here you will find stretcher, then header, then stretcher, then header in the same course. That is why it is called as Flemish bond. Every alternate course starts with a header at the corner known as coin header, and the queen closers are placed next to the coin header. So here you will find coin header. Every alternate course will start from with this coin header. What is the use of this? To avoid the continuity of vertical joints. The coin headers are used after each alternate course. The alternators of each course are placed in the center of the stretcher in course below. So where it is are kept? At the center of stretcher course below. In walls having thickness equal to odd number of half bricks, the bats are used to achieve the bond. In case of this, to achieve the bond, bats are used. Now, There are two types of Flemish bond, single Flemish bond and double Flemish bond. So first is single Flemish bond. This type of bond is a combination of English and Flemish bond. The facing of the wall consists of Flemish bond and backing consists of English bond in each core. Why it is called as single Flemish bond? Because its appearance is as Flemish bond from one side and another side is English bond. So it is called as single Flemish bond. So its appearance is only from front side or face side. It is called as single Flemish bond. The facing of the wall consists of Flemish bond and the backing consists of English bond. This type of bond can be adopted for walls having thickness at least equal to 1.5 brick thick. This is possible only for 1.5 brick thick. This bond is adopted to present the attractive appearance and to ensure full strength in brick work. So now here you can see, here alternate stretchers and headers are laid in the same course. So this is a Flemish bond. Here a single course is complete of header of stretcher. It is called English bond. So from back side this is English bond, from front side this is called Flemish bond, and that's why it is called as single Flemish bond. Now coming to double Flemish bond, means from both the sides its appearance is like Flemish bond. In double Flemish bond, each course present the same appearance both in the front and back face. In each course, the alternate headers and stretchers are laid. This type of bond is economical and presents better appearance than English bond. It is weaker than English bond. This gives good appearance with compared to English bond, but this bond is weaker. Why it is weaker? Because in case of this, brick beds are permitted. As brick beds are permitted, so there will be number of vertical joints. If number of vertical joints are more, so obviously strength will be less, right? So it can be constructed in one brick thick wall having same appearance on both the beds. So practically whatever bond is used in the construction industry, it comes under double Flemish bond. Please remember, whatever bond is used in the construction industry, it is always a double Flemish bond. So we have seen the elevation of double Flemish bond. So this is the elevation of double Flemish bond, and now this is the plan for first, third and fifth, and this is for second, fourth and sixth courses. ये फर्स्ट कोर्स कसा राहील असं राहील, सेकंड कोर्स कसा राहील असं राहील, थर्ड कोर्स असं राहील, फोर्थ कोर्स पुन्हा असं राहील, राईट? दिस इज फॉर 1.5 ब्रिक. वाय इट इज 1.5? बिकॉज दिस इज फुल ब्रिक, दिस इज हाफ ब्रिक, ऑलरेडी वी हॅव डिस्कस. अँड हियर कॉइन्स आर यूज टू अवॉइड द व्हर्टिकलिटी ऑफ जॉईंट. सो नाव कमिंग टू कंपॅरिझन बिटवीन इंग्लिश बॉन्ड अँड फ्लेमिश बॉन्ड. सो नाव व्हेरी इझिली यू कॅन कंपेअर. ऑल्सो ड्युरिंग युअर कंपॅरिझन ॲट द एंड यू कॅन प्रोव्हाइड द स्केचेस. हियर यू कॅन गिव्ह द प्लॅन ऑफ English bond, here you can give the plan of Flemish bond. So very easily you can list out, already we have discussed. What we have discussed, very easily you can remember, this bond consists of headers and stretcher in the alternate courses. So each course is of stretcher, matlab means you can say the single course is of stretcher and second course is of header. This bond consists of headers and stretchers laid in the alternative courses, alternate courses of headers and stretchers. This bond consists of headers and stretchers laid alternately in the same course. Here headers and stretchers are laid alternatively in the same course, and here there are the alternate courses of headers and stretchers. It is the strongest of all the bond. This bond is the strongest. Why it is strongest? Because brick beds are not used. It is less strong compared to English bond because here brick beds are permitted. It provides rough appearance especially for one brick thick wall. The appearance of this English bond is little bit poor, less with compared to this. This provides good appearance for all thickness of walls. Much attention is not required in providing this bond because here full bricks are used. Special attention is required in providing this bond because here brick beds are permitted. Why full attention is required? Because in case of brick bed, there will be number of vertical joints and verticality should be avoided. For that purpose, more attention is required. Progress of work is more here. Progress of work is more because full bricks are used. Progress of work is less because beds are used. It is costly because the use of brick beds is not allowed. This is economical. Flemish bond, brick beds are used, so this is economical. So this is all about various types of bonds.